We know that there have been many news reports very recently that had the facts wrong. If you go back to a couple of weeks ago, you'll notice that one paper in particular, three times in a row, relied upon information that was immediately batted down as false. And this entire thing is just a rush to judgment.
Well, so as the mainstream media whips itself into another Russian collusion frenzy, what does mainstream America think? Is this crisis du jour another overblown attempt to discredit the Trump administration? Joining me now is former senior advisor to George W. Bush, Karl Rove. Who better to bring in to discuss this? Karl, at what point does the American public say enough is enough? You know, has this been grossly overblown?
Well, this certainly, this aspect of it certainly has. Let's think about this way. How do we know what appeared in the newspaper? It's because somebody who is a U.S. government official leaked something to the Washington Post. Well, how do they know that this happened? They know it from intercepts, ostensibly, from the ambassador, the Russian ambassador, talking back home. Look, the Russians, if they want to communicate, if the Russian ambassador wants to communicate with Moscow in a way that is not interceptable by U.S. Intelligence agencies, he could do so. So obviously this was transmitted in the clear. And, you know, I agree with Charles Krauthammer on this one. Yeah. This is an attempt, I think, to basically by the Russians to continue to play in American politics and to undermine the confidence in our government by, in an open channel, the Russian ambassador saying something to Moscow, which then gets picked up in an intercept, which then gets leaked by somebody who does not have the best interests of the United States at heart, but has their own personal political interest in diminishing the president. But my suspicion is that the intelligence community looked at this and said, whoa, wait a minute, this is Kislyakov pulling our beard.
You know, Karl, a Russian lawmaker said today that they would use nukes if the U.S. or NATO enters Crimea. Does that sound like an administration that's back-channeling or colluding with Russia?
Well, this is a typical bravado that we see of the Putin regime. A minor parliamentarian goes to a conference in Central Europe in order to intimidate Western parliamentarians by saying, if you try and recover the Crimea, we'll use nuclear weapons. Well, first of all, Russian military doctrine is not to use nuclear weapons as a first response, but as a last response. And, you know, the idea that this somehow or another is something new is ridiculous. But what is new is that... well, it's not itself new, but a continuing effort by the Russians to influence our allies in Western Europe by saying we're the toughest kid on the block, which is actually not very true. No.